went to work for her that summer. A teenage kid so far from home. She was a lonely widow woman, hell-bent to make it on her own. We were 1,000 miles from nowhere. We did as far as I could see, both needing something from each other, not knowing yet what that might be. Till she came to me one evening, hot cup of coffee and a smile, and a dress that I was certain she hadn't worn in quite a while. There was a difference in her laughter, there was a softness in her eyes, and on the air there was a hunger even a boy could recognize. She had a need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, to watch the storm in all its wonder raging in her lover's eyes. She had the right to heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind. Our only dream to bend, burning both ends of the night. That summer wind was all around me, nothing between us but the night. And I told her that I'd never. She softly whispered, "That's alright." Then I washed her hands of leather, turned to velvet in a touch. There's never been another summer when I've ever learned so much. We had a need to feel the thunder, to chase the lightning from the sky, to watch the storm in all its wonder raging in each other's eyes. We had to ride the heat of passion like a comet burning bright, rushing headlong in the wind. Our only dreams have been burning both ends of the night. With the moonlight and the lace, and I rarely held another when I haven't seen her face. And every time I pass a wheat field and watch her dancing in the wind, although I know it isn't real, I just can't help.